Modern athletes use a vital protein supplement to enhance muscle growth and development. This is none other than whey protein, one of the byproducts of cheese production, which has been an amazing boost for athletic performance and body protein recovery after exercise. Whey protein's proven useful not only for athletes, as its intake can increase the production of amino acids in the human body, it has high organic and saline content. In a world where fitness and athleticism are the order of the day, whey protein supplements promises low fats and carbs, a characteristic which gives it a little edge above other options. Millions of people all over the world consume whey protein as part of their diet. Other potential benefits of whey protein including helping with weight loss, maintenance of nutritional levels, and reducing cholesterol levels in the body. As a finished product, whey protein is ready for consumption in a fine powder form, but its production process is not as easy as it looks to the eye. Without further ado, let us embark on a journey of how whey protein is made. As a dairy product and a byproduct of the cheese production process, the making of whey protein starts from milk obtained from cows. These cows are well fed and bred, and are milked as many as 3 to 4 times a day, depending on the lactation of each cow. These dairy animals must be well taken care of to ensure that the milk extracted from them is of the best quality. After this, the tons of milk are stored in large refrigerated containers and transported to the cheese processing plant. The proximity or an effective transport mechanism between the farm and the cheese processing facility is important due to the perishable nature of the raw product. On arrival at the plant, the raw milk undergoes the process of pasteurization. Pasteurization is a method devised by the famous French microbiologist Louis Pasteur to ensure the elimination of harmful bacteria from food products to promote their preservation and fitness for consumption. There are two types of pasteurization commonly used in dairy processing: high-temperature short-time pasteurization and ultra-high-temperature pasteurization. In high-temperature short-time pasteurization, the milk is subject to a high temperature, typically less than 100 degrees Celsius, within 15 seconds, and then cool. In ultra-high-temperature pasteurization, the temperature is raised to around 140 degrees Celsius for about 1 or 2 seconds. Milk produced through ultra-high-temperature pasteurization tends to last longer without refrigeration. Nevertheless, the end goal for either method is to kill dangerous pathogens and bacteria, which may be harmful to humans. At the end of the pasteurization, the milk protein is composed of roughly 20% whey and 80% casein. The real work starts when separating the whey from the casein. But before we get into this, tests must be performed on the milk to ensure its quality. This test is not confined to this stage, but is performed at every stage of milk production to promote consumer protection and satisfaction. Separating whey from casein involves an affair in large vats between pasteurized milk and enzymes such as rennet, overseen by the rhythmic melody of mechanized stirs and agitators. Rennet is made up of numerous enzymes, such as a proteolytic enzyme, protease, which is responsible for milk coagulation and subsequently the separation of solids, curds, and liquids, whey. The primary active enzyme in rennet, chymosin or renin, is accompanied by other enzymes such as pepsin and lipase. Casein, the predominant protein in milk that crystallizes into curds, is a primary ingredient in cheese preparation. As it stands, liquid whey is a co-dairy product beside cheese, just as bitumen and petroleum are to crude oil. For the next process, the liquid whey, composed of water, lactose, and minerals, is transferred to a manufacturing facility where it undergoes a second round of pasteurization. This second purification process guarantees the quality and pathogen-free nature of the liquid whey. The next step is the concentration and isolation of the liquid whey, separating the whey protein concentrate from the sugar, lactose, and fats. There are two main methods of achieving this, which are membrane filtration processing and ion exchange processing. Before the advent of this process, whey protein used to be insoluble with a pleasant taste and color. These filtration systems guaranteed the solubility of whey protein and the reduction in the fat and lactose concentration in whey protein. Membrane filtration is a separation process conducted at cold temperatures, employing porous membranes. These membranes, varying in pore sizes, effectively remove bacteria, separate fat from whey, permit the passage of carbohydrates and minerals, and retain whey proteins. Membrane filtration technology emerged as a practical solution for whey recovery due to its ability to separate various whey components based on size and contain only low concentrations of valuable proteins and other biochemical substances. Ion exchange technology in whey protein production involves passing whey through a column containing specialized resins with charged functional groups, selectively capturing protein components while allowing other components to pass through. This method enables high-purity protein separation. The pasteurized whey is filtrated based on the net charge of its components, which leads to the retention of high-quality proteins, such as immunoglobulin and lactoferrin. Other components, such as fats and lactose, are filtered away to make other products. Ion exchange processing employs pH adjustments, achieved by adding chemical agents like hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide to produce protein separation by modifying the protein's electrical charge and enabling their attachment to resins in separation containers. The essence of this stage is to remove the remaining moist substance in the concentrated whey protein and convert the whey into a powdered form. The whey protein liquid undergoes drying in a dryer equipped with hot and cold air streams for removing water and separating solids from the liquid. At this stage, the filtered whey is conveyed into large industrial evaporators, also known as spray dryers. The liquid whey is first atomized. This means that it's transformed into small droplets. Large industrial nozzles are utilized in spraying the liquid whey into droplets. These droplets are then placed in large containers known as drying chambers, where the real drying takes place. The whey particles are collected as the semi-finished dry product, the whey protein. Interestingly, the drying process involves a controlled temperature as the excessively high temperature of the dry air can affect the protein quality. On completion of this stage, the whey protein is introduced into the industrial mixer. The mixer helps to further eliminate any moisture in the particles, drying the whey further. Additionally, mixing helps certain production facilities to introduce flavors, vitamins, and other additives to the whey protein. This is done according to the nutritional policy, which can be found on the nutritional information labels on their products. Mixing also ensures uniformity of color and taste of the now finished whey protein. The next stage after this is the packaging stage. However, before this, the whey protein is subjected to several evaluations. This is to ensure the quality and consumption worthiness of the product. Consumer protection remains at the core of food processing and required standards must be followed. Packaging is done by a filling machine which fills containers placed on a conveyor belt. The filling machine is designed to fill each container with the same amount of the finished product. The filling machine draws the product from a bulk container which stores the protein. In the highly automated industrial process, each container is weighed to ascertain conformity with the required weight. Outliers are separated for repackaging. After the packaging has been completed, each product will be wrapped with a label composed of nutritional information, the product name, details of the producers, and other vital information by a labeling machine. In addition, some companies may decide to insert a scoop or spoon in each product for use by the consumers. After this, quality standards tests are conducted to ensure the finished products are safe for consumers. Products will be graded on color, taste, mixture, and other relevant parameters. After the labeling process and the quality standard tests have been performed, the finished product is crowned with a plastic ring on the lid of the container housing the whey protein. Following these, the products can then be sent out for wholesale distribution and onward to the final consumers. Given your newfound knowledge about whey protein, I believe you'll better appreciate the delicate craftsmanship and science behind every sip you take of this phenomenal supplement next time. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this.